Hi, in this video I will show you how to clean and repair your portafilter for Saeco Poemia. So first we have to remove the three bolts on the bottom of the portafilter. So we will use a Phillips screwdriver and we are going to remove them. Be careful to not lose these bolts, because they are not regular bolts, they are stainless steel bolts, and they need to be stainless steel because there is a lot of water and moisture here, and if the bolts are normal, they can rust and you will have a problem to remove them. So if you lose the stainless steel bolts, you can use only brass bolts, but nothing else, stainless steel or brass. So we have to remove the three bolts with the bushings, are also very important, don't lose them. So we can see after removing the three bolts what's inside the portafilter. So we gently move the handle. And now you can see, actually this portafilter is not very dirty. I see much more dirtier, but it's a good idea to clean all this area here and here, because when it's you have a water and moisture, there is a bacteria and start to smell bad, and you drink coffee from here. So it's a good idea every, let's say, 5 or 4 months to disassemble the portafilter and clean it. So let me show you what I use for cleaning these coffee accumulations here. It's for milk and for coffee also, and what I am doing is it's 28 grams, and I put it in this type of bottle, and it's very concentrated, because here is you have to put it in 2 liters of hot water, but I'm just putting all this chemical inside the, let's say, 800 maybe 1000 milliliters bottle, and I spray the parts and wait there the coffee is dissolved and clean them. And I prefer more concentrated to be, so I don't need to wait a long time. So this is the chemical. You can use something else, but this is for this job. Now we have to remove the springs, and so we will use flat screwdriver and push, and you can see the click here. And now we release this plastic from the body of the portafilter. So we have to gently remove this small spring. Very often people lose this, and this is very important. So this is, you can see the other spring here, and what it's more common, sometimes one of these plastic pieces here will broke, and if this is broke and the spring is released this way, you don't have, this is new one, you don't have this motion. So if you don't have this, this spring is not working properly, the big spring. So we remove the spring. Second. Okay. So we can spray this and clean, and we remove the screen, metal screen. You can see this one also, you can see you can see light, but if you leave your coffee inside the portafilter and don't remove it from the machine and clean it, with time most of these holes will not move water from here to the portafilter. So it's very important to clean after you make coffee, every time you clean your portafilter. So we just push this here, and you can see this plastic with the rubber here. Okay, so this plastic is okay, I can clean it, but I will replace these parts with new, because I don't want to make a video very long to watch me how clean the parts. So you can see how much dirt. So this with the moisture will cause bacteria and bad smell and bad taste in your coffee, and will the portafilter will not make good espresso. I want to show you a different type of this aluminum. You can see here is different, but you have to clean this. Okay, so we remove the old parts. And something else first, if your metal screen is very dirty, you don't use needle and poke the holes, because I can show you here, you can see how deformed it is, and the holes are bigger, and this screen, it's not going to make a good coffee. Okay, so if you want to clean this coffee particulates here, you can use the chemical and leave it, but for much longer time, maybe for an hour, and then use a toothbrush and remove it. If you want to make it quickly, you have to use pliers and something to burn the coffee. So I use this type of, you have to move all the time, because you don't have to make the metal red, because it will warp. With a few seconds you will see smoke. When you see smoke, that means that the coffee burns. So you can stop for a second, you can, you will see burnt coffee removed. Then when you see the all holes are okay, you leave it on the side, don't put it in the water, because you will warp the metal. So it's hot, you leave it for a 2-3 minutes, and then clean it more and install it on the portafilter. So, wait a minute, now we will clean the handle. How are we going to clean the handle? And we will clean it 100%. So first we have to remove the back side of the handle. You can see, let me show how much dirt is in here. And you have a hole here, and the handle is hollow. So if you want to clean 100% of your handle, let me show you. We spray here, we can, right? I'm not going to make it really good. You can spray, you can see here also, it's not so you make it like this. You can leave it for with the chemical for 2-3-4-5 minutes. Okay, so everything is dissolved. Okay, And here, of course, we have to spray. And we have, again, I'm just making this so you can see how much dirt and things that you don't want to drink are here. So you make it, sorry, forgetting where is the camera sometime. So let's say it's clean. I can clean it later much more, but let's say we remove most of the, of course you can clean this also, just making it fast. You can see how bad it is here, yeah? It's a lot of, it's not 100% clean, but you know how to remove this, and you know here it has to be clean. So now of course if you reuse these springs here, you make it clean also, okay, but I'm not going to bore you with this. So I only need first this plastic and this rubber. So this rubber is, you have to know how to put it the right way, because you can see here is a channel. From one side is, let's say, 1 millimeter, from the other side the thickness is 1.5 millimeter. So the 1 millimeter part of the rubber has to go down to the aluminum. So let me put this. Okay. Okay. So the smaller pieces of rubber goes down, and with the 1.5 millimeters, let's say, is up. So the taller piece of the rubber goes to the screen, the metal screen. So we put this, and now of course you will clean this piece here. You can see how it's now. This piece of the spring has to be up this way, not because you can, if you can turn it back, this here will go back. So now we have the rubber, this big disc plastic, and we have to click this here to this piece here. So you have, let me show you, two indentations here and two holes here. So the indentations goes these two, and this hole to this plastic, okay? And when you, because it's new, when you push, be careful where you push, because if you broke these two plastics, on them you have to attach the small spring. So with your finger push here, and you have to be on the holes and just click. Okay, now we have to install the small spring. The small spring from one side is bigger, the end from the other side is smaller. So the big end goes inside here and smaller here. And you can see how it's working. So we push this spring is going on the top, and now you have to see the strong spring has to go. Wait a minute. This piece here has to go in this notch here. So we turn. We know where is this. So you can see the holes has to appear on the right side. See? From on the right side of these channels here. So I can make this, and I know the spring is on the right place because I have a resistance from the spring. So I return the bolts. Of course you can clean the bolts, you can clean everything. I just make it fast so you don't need to watch me how I clean different stuff. Okay. And now we have to put this spring here. Okay. And the new screen filter. A new clean and rebuild your Portafilter. So what is the most common problem with most people? They are saying there is when they put coffee inside the Portafilter and the machine starts to make the coffee, you start to see the drops of water around here. So what can be the problem? First, of course, because most of the people when they make their coffee, let me show you, this is disassemble the machine, but I want to show you. And when you make your coffee, you take your cup of coffee, drink it, and leave the Portafilter with the coffee on the machine. This is not good because you make on this rubber, this is inside the machine, okay, you create a channel here, and this with the time stop to make a good seal, and you can have leaks. And something else, you can see this rubber here is round and nice, and this one is like cone shaped because with the time the screen filter push on this rubber and change the profile of the rubber, and this make this rubber here also push a little bit against this rubber, and when this is wear and this is deformed, you don't have a good seal here. So every time when you make your coffee, after 10-20 seconds, remove your Portafilter, clean it with water and put it not on the machine but somewhere around the machine, so you don't destroy this rubber and this rubber. So something else very important, again with time, people, if these two rubbers are wear, you start to lock your Portafilter. When the machine is new, you have to lock it until it's in the middle of the machine. But when this start to leak and wear, you start to push more and more to the right side. This means you have to see and replace this rubber and the rubber on the machine. And if you don't, what it's going to happen is, let me show you, this is only the bottom piece where the portafilter locks. So I remove the screens and the rubbers, and I can show you when you continue to lock and lock much more your portafilter, you start to wear here the locking mechanism, I would say. You can see from the right side there is a final stop. You can't go any more else from here when you turn. But here is broken, this piece that stops the portafilter is broken, and this is it's okay. But let me show you how it's wear the plastic. You can see, and this what will do. You can even if you replace the rubber seals, you will continue to have leaks from here with water, because what will happen when this, you can see how it's wear your portafilter when you lock it. Let me just for a second. When you lock on your machine, you can see it's not level to the head of the machine. You will see your portafilter is kind of warp. Where it's wear, it will go down, and it's not be the and it will start to leak. So you have to be, before you buy a new portafilter or something else, you have to inspect actually this locking mechanism here on the coffee machine head. Okay, and if this is okay, you can continue to buy parts for this seal here, or parts for your portafilter. But if this is broken and you have to replace it, it's too expensive to replace it, and it's better to buy a new coffee machine. It's too much trouble, and yeah, you have to replace it. But it's good when you clean your portafilter or rebuild it. It's good to clean also from time to time your screen on the top of the machine here. Let me remove this. And you have a valve inside. Because it's a spring. So sometimes you can see this also gets dirty. You can clean it, because if this is not clean and the water goes from 5-7 of the holes, you don't have a good extraction from the coffee. So 3-5 months when you clean your portafilter, it's a good idea to remove these two screws and clean this metal screen here also. And this is the valve. You have rubber head, and this valve, the rubber mushroom head goes inside, and from here is the spring, because many people are turning it back, and now it doesn't function because this silicone head, mushroom head, has to plug the hole where the boiler water goes inside, outside your coffee machine. So the rubber head first, and then the screen. So here is the spring. Push it like this. And something else, please don't be very careful with these screws. Don't screw them very tight. Look at here, it's okay, and I turn it a little bit more. You don't need to go all the way, okay, easy, because it's good to remove these screws and clean the screen here. So this is how to maintain your coffee machine. Also, I want to talk about the Panareus of the Saeco Poemia. So if you buy a Saeco Poemia, you have this type of Panareo. There is a metal with metal body and with plastic body. Also, if you lose, let's say, this Panareo, you can use the old style, it calls Art Panareo, of course. You can see it's a 6 millimeter pipe, and if it's 6 millimeter, it doesn't matter what kind of coffee machine you have. If it's 6 millimeter pipe, you can use this type of Panareos. Also this, it's for the 6 millimeter pipe, steam pipe. And this is also Saeco Panareo, but it's Art Panareo, and it's not suitable for this job here, because you can see this is the outside piece. Wait. You can see the pipe for this Panareo goes all the way here, and this one will go only to here. And when you put this, it's go very low, and you cannot put your cup with milk. So if you want to replace the standard Panareo, you can use Art Panareo from the old models. So something very interesting. If you have these Panareos, if you want to work very good and to have a good foam on your milk, you have to clean it every time when you use it. If you have a metal Panareo, you can see small hole here. This hole has to be free, so the when you start to make your foam on the milk, the Panareo takes air from here and mix it inside the chamber here with the milk and the steam and make foam. So this has to be clean. You can see the new style Panareo has stand with metal. This also have hole here. Of course, you have to clean it also. If you have plastic, they don't have a hole. You can see a small channel here from where the air going inside. You can see here a little bit of notch. You can see it also on this panel. Let me see where it is. You can see here, here and here. This has to be clean here. And how it works, it actually this little channel bypassing the seal and taking air to mix it again. And here, of course, yeah, this is the cheaper version, plastic version. Of course, you have a seal here, and the channel again bypassing this seal here and take air inside the chamber. If it's plugged, you're not going to have a good foam on your milk. So you have to clean it, and for your Poemia you can use also this type of plastic or metal Art Panareo. So this is for now.